Hello everyone, welcome to LRDA Prep. My name is Sameer Sardana. In this video, I will be discussing the concept of calendar, one of the most important topics for SNAP and other MB/NTS exams point of view. In the recent exam of SNAP, questions from calendar topic were asked. So we will be covering the concept, complete concept of calendar through with the help of this video. So let's start with the basic concept here. If you come across this type of question, what day of the week was it on 50th of August 1987? Before you solve this question, there are some points that everybody should know. Some theoretical concept related to the calendar that you should know is the concept of the number of odd days. So odd days concept is something that you need to know if you want to solve the questions of calendar, odd days concept, right? So just keep this in mind, right? Just keep some important theoretical concept in your mind. The number of odd days concept is exactly similar to the concept of cyclicity. For example, if I say that one is, let's say there's a day one, and let's say the day on it is Monday, then there is day two, the day on it is Tuesday, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 3 means it's Wednesday, 4 means it's Thursday, 5 means it's Friday, 6 means it's Saturday, and 7 means it's Sunday. Now, when the number 8 will come, you see that automatically the number on 8, the number will be again, the day will again be Monday. On 9th, it will be again Tuesday. And on 10th, it would be Wednesday. 11th, it will be Thursday. 12th, it will be Friday. 13th, it will be Saturday. And 14th, it will be Sunday. So see that after a period of 7 days, right, this complete cycle of Monday to Sunday will keep on repeating. And if you observe carefully, right, again the number 15 will come over here, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, and so on till 21, right? So see this, you see that all these numbers, right, 1, 8, 15, all these numbers are of the form of 7k plus 1, right? That means all the numbers when divided by 7 give you a remainder of 1. On that, on all such numbers, the day will be taken as Monday, right? And if you look at all these days, 2, 9, 16, all these numbers when divided by 7 will give you a remainder of 2. So can I say all these numbers are of the form of 7k plus 2? And look at this number, it is 3, it is 10, and then 17. All these numbers are of the form of 7k plus 3 and so on, right? And finally, these numbers, you see, are the exact multiple of 7. These are the numbers which when divided by 7 give you a remainder of 0. So this remainder is basically will tell us the number of odd days. When you divide some number of days with 7, and the remainder that you will be getting is known as the odd days concept, right? An odd day 1 means it's Monday. Odd days 2 means it's Tuesday. Odd days 3 means it's Wednesday. Odd days 4 means it's Thursday. Odd days 5 means it's Friday. Odd days 6 means Saturday. If the number of odd days are 7, the day would be Sunday. This is something that you need to keep in your mind, right? So all you have to do is just check out the number of odd days, right? So how do you get the number of odd days? By dividing the total number of days. By dividing the total number of days with 7, and the remainder that you will be getting will tell us the remainder, the value of the remainder is the number of odd days, right? So this is the main concept. And in addition to that, some more information that some more theoretical information that you need to keep in your mind is that if I'm talking about a period of 100 years, right? If I'm talking about a period of 100 years, right, in 100 year periods, right, this is something that you need to keep in your mind, the number of odd days. In a period of 100 years, a number of odd days will be equivalent to 5. Why it is so? See that in one year, we have total 365 days, right? But in one leap year, the number of days are 366, right? And Everybody know that every fourth year is a leap year. Every fourth year is a leap year, right? But so just keep this in mind, right? So the point number one that you need to keep in your mind, every fourth year is a leap year, which will have 366 days. Every fourth year is a leap year, right? That means that leap year will have 366 days. So that year where the days in the number of February are 29. The second point that you need to keep in your mind, every fourth year is a leap year, but a year which is a multiple of 100, right? Multiple of 100 is not a leap year. Multiple of 100 is not a leap year, not a leap year, right? These are the theoretical concepts, right? There's no need to learn the derivation behind it. All you have to do is just keep this in mind. Multiple of 100 is not a leap year. For example, if I'm talking about a 300, right? 300 year, right? A 300th year, you see, is a multiple of 4. But it's also a multiple of 100, so you will call it as a non-leap year. So in 300th year, the number of days will be 365 instead of 366. But if I'm talking about 304, 304th year, in this particular year, the number of days will be 366, right? The point number three that you need to keep in your mind, which is multiple of 400. Now this is a multiple of 100, right? It's also a multiple of 4, but because it's a multiple of 400, you are supposed to take it as a leap year, right? So if I ask you what will be the number of days in 1600th year, right? The number of days in 1600th year will be 366. These are the three things that you need to keep in mind. Every fourth year is a leap year. That means the number of days will be 366. A year which is a multiple of 100 is not a leap year. Year which is a multiple of 100 as well as a multiple of 400 will be called as a leap year. Three things, and you will be able to solve every question of calendar, right? Now with this help, if I want to find out the number of odd days in 100 year, 100 in a period of 100 years, in a period of 100 years, what are the number of odd days? The number of odd days are 5. Let's learn the derivation behind it. See that in 1 year, the number of days are 366. So when you divide 365 by 7, the remainder that you'll be getting would be 1. So in 1 year, the number of odd days are 1, right? In 366, in a leap year, when you divide 366 by 7, the remainder that you will be getting will be 2. So that means the number of odd days in a leap year are 2. So now in a 100 year period, every fourth year is a leap year. So can I say there will be 24 leap year? Why 24? Every fourth year is a leap year, so number of leap years should be 25. No, 100 multiple is not a leap year. That the number of days in a 100th multiple will be taken as 365 instead of 366. So there will be 76 non-leap year. In a leap year, we have just found the number of odd days are 2. So in 24 leap year, the number of odd days will be 48. And in a non-leap year, the number of odd days are 1. So in 76 non-leap year, the number of odd days will be 76. Now you keep on dividing the number by 7 unless you are getting the number of odd days which are less than 7. Divide 78 by 7, the number of days will be 6. Divide 76 by 7, the number of odd days will be 6. Right? Now 6 plus 6 is 12. 12 and divide by 7, the number of odd days will be 5. Now this is a very important information that you need to keep in your mind. In a period of 100 year, the number of odd days are 5, right? So 4 points that I want you to keep in mind is to understand the concept of odd days, right? In addition to that, you need to understand in a 100 year period, number of odd days are 5. Every fourth year is a leap year with 366 days. Every fourth year is a leap year, but a year which is a multiple of 100 is not a leap year. Every fourth year is a leap year, a multiple of 100 is not a leap year, but a number which is a multiple of 400 is a leap year, so the number of days will be 366. The number of days 366 means the number of odd days are 2. Why? Because when you divide it by 7, the remainder obtained is 2. 1 year is 365, 365 by 7, the remainder will be 1. So the number of odd days in one normal year will be 1. And 1 odd day means Monday, 2 odd days mean Tuesday, 3 odd days mean Wednesday, and so on. Now let's use this information to get to the answer of the question that you can see on the screen. See that? What I'm supposed to find out is what day of the week was it on 15th of August 1987. See that, guys? 15th August 1987. So how do you approach it? So this is something, this is the year that you need to concentrate on. Divide this year into three parts. 1600 years, right? And then take the next part as 300 years, right? 1600 plus 300 are 1900. Now, 1900, and if you look at 87 can be divided into two parts, a period of 86 years, and then the last 87th year on which we are supposed to find out the day. Now, when you talk about a 1600 period, the number of odd days will be zero. What I'm writing down here is the number of odd days, right? Number of odd days, right? Now, in a period of 1600, number of odd days are zero. How do we get to know this? Because we have just derived in 100 years period, the number of odd days are 100, number of odd days are 5. So in a 300 year period, the number of odd days will be 5 into 3, that is 15. 15 when divided by 7 will give you a remainder of 1. So in a 300 period, the number of odd days are 1. But when we talk about the year of 400, right, the number of odd days will be 1, right? 400 can be divided into 300 plus the last 100 years, right? Now this will have 1 odd day, right? And if you do the calculation for 100 years, you see that here, the 400th year will be a leap year. So therefore, in the last 100 year period, there will be 25 leap year and 75 non-leap year, right? And this will give you 6 odd days. 6 odd days plus 1 is 7 odd days. 7 by 7 is 0. So in a period of 400, the number of odd days are 0. In a period of odd days, if the number of odd days are 0, so in a period of 1600, the number of odd days will also be 0. In a period of 300, the number of odd days you can see are 1. Now, this is something that you need to calculate. In 86 year, every 4th year is a leap year. So if you divide 86 by 4, you will get the quotient value of 21. So there will be a 21 leap year, and the rest of the year will be non-leap year. 6 minus 1, 5, 8 minus 2, 6, 65 non-leap year. 21 leap year will give you total 42 odd days. 65 non-leap years will give you 65 odd days. 42 by 7 will give you a remainder of 0, so 0 odd days. And 65 by 7 will give you a remainder of 2, so 2 odd days. Now, in the period of 87th year, you see that we are supposed to go till 15th of August. So there will be January, February, March, April, May, June, July. And then in August, you have a period of 15 days. Now in January, the number of days are 31. So you have 3 odd days. February, 87th is a non-leap year. Number of days will be 28, 0 odd day. March, you will have 3 odd days. April, 30 by 7, remainder will be 2 odd days. May is 31, 31 by 7, the remainder would be 3 odd days. June, you'll have 2. July, you'll have 3. In August, there are total 15 days, the number of odd days will be 1, right? Now, 3 plus 3, 6, plus 2, 8, plus 3, 11. 8 plus 3, 11, plus 2, 13. 13 plus 3, 16, plus 1, 17. 17 by 7 will give you a remainder of 3, so 3 odd days, right? So total number of odd days are 1, 1, plus 2, 3, 3 plus 3, 6. Now 6 odd days mean it will be Saturday, right? 6 odd days means the day on this day would be Saturday. So that's the answer of the question, which is option number B. This is the way to solve the calendar question. Right, so just keep all the points that I have just told you in this video, And based on these theoretical concepts, we'll be solving more questions of calendar in the upcoming videos. Thank you so much for watching the video. And you can subscribe to Unacademy Plus subscription using my referral code LRDSME to access all of my Plus courses that I'm taking for CAT 2021 and for other MBA entrance exams preparation. Also, these are my upcoming courses that I'll be launching in the coming days. The courses are Arithmetic Without Formula with 1000 question course. Right, this is a course that I will be launching in the month of January. It's a one-stop solution for algebra course with 750 question practice, and there will be comprehensive geometry course with 750 practice question course. Right, so you can join all these courses on Unacademy Plus. Use my referral code Unacademy, LRDSMIR, and there's also an iconic membership that you can purchase, and you can use my referral code LRDSMIR. Under the iconic membership, you will be given personal mentorship, test analysis and reports, other management entrance test preparations, and all benefits of Plus will also be included under this course. This is an Ask a Doubt feature that I've been made live recently on Unacademy Learning App, where you just have to click a question, highlight the question and send it across. You'll get a solution, and this feature is active 24/7. Thank you so much for watching the video. See you in the next part of the video. Thank you.